بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has once again enabled us to meet here and present on this platform to continue our journey with a unique compilation, a unique book that speaks of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Sheikh Abadi Institute has undertaken to revive some of the traditional works of our beautiful heritage with the inner prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brightens our future with our attempts at preserving our past. The Learn to Understand series has started to focus on what is referred to in Cape Town as Diriwayats, which in essence is a qasida, a beautiful rhymed text documented by Al-Imam al-Barzanji, who was a grand scholar in the Haram of Al-Madinatul Munawwara. We've completed the introduction as well as the first riwayah, and we mentioned that Al-Imam al-Barzanji's work consists of 22 individual sets of information. 22 individual sets of information, each one referred to as a riwayah, which literally means a narration. However, in Cape Town, only the first four are generally read. So we concluded with a translation and basic explanation of the first riwayah, as well as we started looking at the second riwayah. And we mentioned last week that the second riwayah, the second narration, the second set of information in this work by Al-Imam al-Barzanji addresses the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's lineage, a list of the names of his forefathers via his father Abdullah and ending by his 20th grandfather, a man by the name of Adnan. And we mentioned, as documented by Imam al-Barzanji as well, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam confirmed his lineage to Adnan. And we also mentioned that Adnan is a great descendant of Nabi Ismail alayhi salam, was the son of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. Because of the length of the second riwayah, we are addressing it in two parts, part A and part B, inshallah. And we concluded with part A. Part A ended by a section that mentions the forefather Adnan and the fact that he, Adnan, is a descendant of Prophet Ismail alayhi salam and his father, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. In English, they would be referred to as Ishmael and Abraham. May Allah have peace on them both and all the divine emissaries of Allah. We also noted the fact that detail of this link to Ishmael and Abraham has not been mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we note here two parts of his lineage. From his father to Adnan, that link, that chain is documented and clear. Whereas from Adnan to Nabi Ismail alayhi salam, we do not have sure detail of it. There are records of names, but the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam chose to abstain from mentioning any detail regarding that part of the chain, from Adnan to Ismail, even though he and all the Arabs confirmed that Adnan is a descendant of Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. So we continue with the second part of riwayah number two. So riwayah number two, the second riwayah is long. We divided it into two parts. We started with the first part last week, and now we conclude, inshallah, in this session with the second part. Here we go. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَعَدْنَانُ بِلَا رَيْبٍ عِنْدَ ذَوِي الْعُلُومِ النَّسَبِيَّةِ إلى الذبيح إسماعيل نسبته ومنتماه ومنتهاه. See the rhyme is starting once again. The first line ends with the iyah and the second line ends with the ah sound. What does this mean? He says, وَعَدْنَان بِلَا رَيْبٍ, and عَدْنَان without a doubt. بِلَا رَيْبٍ means without a doubt. عِنْدَ ذَوِ الْعُلُومِ النَّسَبِيَّةِ, by the possessors of the knowledge of genealogy. العلوم, the plural of علم, the science or knowledge. النَّسَبِيَّةِ, oh, genealogy, the nasab. عَدْنَان without a doubt, by the possessors of the knowledge of genealogy, إِلَى الذَّبِيحِ إِسْمَعِيلَ نِسْبَتُهُ, نِسْبَتُهُ, his relation, وَمُنْتَمَاهُ, his origin, وَمُنْتَهَاهُ, and his end, is to who? إِلَى الذَّبِيحِ إِسْمَعِيلَ, to the slaughtered Ishmael. Why they refer to Nabi Ismail alayhi salam as the slaughtered Ismail? Because we know the narrative, the story of the dream that Abraham, Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, had regarding slaughtering his son, and the fact that Nabi Ismail alayhi salam accepted this instruction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and supported his father in doing what Allah wanted of him. And we got to a point where Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam was ready to slaughter Nabi Ismail alayhi salam, and Allah made it such that the knife that he had sharpened and prepared did not cut the young boy. So if it was not for Allah's decree, then he would have been slaughtered, and he was prepared for it. So he's regarded as the slaughtered one because he sacrificed his ego. He sacrificed any worldly affiliation and connection for the command and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, we know, Allah replaced that situation there with a gift, a ram that was slaughtered in Nabi Ismail alayhi salam's place. Anyway, so what does he say here? He confirms that Adnan, without a doubt, his relation, his nisbah, and his origin is muntama, and his end, the end of his chain, muntaha, is to who? Ila dhabih Ismail, to the one who was slaughtered, or almost slaughtered, who was none other than Ismail alayhi salam. And this is confirmed عند ذوي العلوم النسبية, by the possessors of the knowledge of genealogy. Okay. So we listen to Hadi Osman reading this piece. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
إلى الذبيح إسماعيل نسبته ومنتماه ومنتهاه.
Okay, he said nisbatahu, it's nisbatuhu. Okay, grammatically. So, just practice it once more with me before we continue.
وَعَدْنَانُ بِلَا رَيْبٍ عِنْدَ ذَوِي الْعُلُومِ النَّسَبِيَّةِ.
Again.
وَعَدْنَانُ بِلَا رَيْبٍ عِنْدَ ذَوِي الْعُلُومِ النَّسَبِيَّةِ. إلى الذبيح إسماعيل نسبته ومنتماه ومنتهى.
وعدنان بلا ريب عند ذوي العلوم النسبية. إلى الذبيح إسماعيل نسبته ومنتماه ومنتهى. Next piece.
فأعظم به من عقد تألقت كواكبه الدرية وكيف لا والسيد الأكرم صلى الله عليه وسلم واسطته المنتقى.
فأعظم به من عقد. So what a great necklace this is. فأعظم به من عقد. What a great necklace this is. تألقت كواكبه الدرية, whose pearl-like stars have glimmered and shone. Kawakib, stars, ad-durriya, the pearl like stars تألقت have glimmered and shone. You with me? He is drawing an analogy between the forefathers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and glimmering stars. They, the forefathers, they are the stars of this necklace. They are the stars of this necklace. And in any necklace around your neck, you have a centerpiece that is the most expensive part and the most valued part of the necklace. You with me? So he says, this is a great necklace. What a great necklace this is, whose pearl-like stars have glimmered. But وَكَيْفَلَا? And why not? Why should this not be regarded as a great necklace? وَالسَّيِّدُ الْأَكْرَمُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ Whilst the noble leader, صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَاسِطَتُهُ الْمُنْتَقَى is its selected centerpiece. وَاسِطَة, centerpiece. الْمُنْتَقَى, a selected and purified and chosen centerpiece. We just need to add there after noblest leader, صلى الله عليه وسلم, is its selected centerpiece. You understand what he's saying? Say, this is a great necklace of lineage, great necklace of names of forefathers, not only names, but record of forefathers. And each forefather is as if a shining, glimmering star. وَكَيْفَلَا? How can this not be regarded? How can this not be regarded as a great necklace whilst the most honorable or the noblest leader, that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, is the selected centerpiece of this necklace. So we hear Abdul Hadi reading it. فَأَعْظِمْ بِهِ
كواكب الدرية وكيف لا والسيد الأكرم صلى الله عليه وسلم واسطة المنتقى
واسطة ال actually it's better واسطته المنتقى the who goes back to the عقد refers back to the necklace واسطته its centerpiece. You with me? And al-muntaqa is sifa, an adjective for wasita. Beautiful. Now we see a shift, a change in the rhyme in the next two sets. Instead of having a iya and a, see what he has here, a, and then a hamza, a. Nasabun tahsibul ula bihulahu. And when you stop, you say bihulah. Qalladatha nujumaha al-jawza'u. When you stop, you say al-jawza'. Nasabun a lineage. تحسب العلا. You consider exalted. يحلاه with its adornments. قلدتها نجومها الجوزاء. الجوزاء is the name of a constellation of stars in our galaxy. And this constellation of stars is known as the Gemini constellation. It's as if the constellation of Gemini, قلدتها, has adorned this beautiful necklace and its adornments with what? Nujumaha, with its stars. See what he's saying here in metaphor, like the poet is. He says it's as if this constellation of stars has beautified and adorned this necklace with its stars. Ya salam. So the Arabs knew the placement of stars, and they used to use it, astronomy. They used to use it to find their paths at night, to find direction at night. And this is mentioned in the Quran. It's a science that we have generally lacked enthusiasm for and lost to a certain degree because of all our modern methods of finding direction. But the Arabs were very familiar with astronomy and the placements of stars and the names of certain selections of stars, like this one. Al-Jawza was the name of a selection of stars, which in English is Gemini. And he says here, you consider this lineage exalted with all its adornments, but it's as if that group of stars have adorned and placed on this jewelry of the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's as if this constellation has placed its stars on this what? On this lineage. Okay.
نسب تحسب العلا بحلاه قلدتها نجومها الجوزاء.
نسب تحسب العلا بحلاه قلدتها نجومها الجوزاء.
So the rhyme changed, and I said it's two sets. This is the first set where the rhyme has changed, and here's the second one.
حبذا عقد سؤدد وفخار أنت فيه اليتيمة العصماء.
He has shifted the address here from third person to second person. He addresses Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and says,
حبذا عقد سؤدد وفخار.
What an excellent necklace of leadership and pride. أنت فيه اليتيمة العصماء. In which you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are al-yatimatul asma, are the guarded pearl. Al-yatima is a unique, one-of-a-kind, special pearl. Because yatim means an orphan. There's nothing like it. It stands alone. Naam. So al-yatima was the individual, one-of-a-kind pearl. Al-asma, from asama, means protected.
Habbada, what an excellent necklace of leadership and pride. أنت فيه اليتيمة العصماء.
You are in it the guarded pearl. In the previous lines, in the previous section, he referred to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم as the واسطة العقد, as the centerpiece of the chain, which is the most expensive piece of any necklace, any chain. And here he refers to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم as the guarded pearl. Can you hear the love in the words, the love that he has for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So let's hear.
حَبَّذَا عِقْدُ سُؤْدَدٍ.
And the word سُؤْدَد, I've seen it in some texts without the Hamza. So they will say سُؤْدَد. But the origin is سُؤْدَد. And I think Hadi Osman reads it without the Hamza. We have a choice. But I prefer it with the Hamza. Good. So those were two sets with the rhyme changed. And here it goes on and back to the original rhyme.
وَأَكْرِمْ بِهِ مِن نَسَبٍ طَهَّرَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مِن سِفَاحِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ.
Karam means nobility. And how noble a lineage it is. وَأَكْرِمْ بِهِ مِن نَسَبٍ. How noble a lineage it is. طَهَرَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Which Allah, the Exalted, has purified. Allah has purified this lineage. From what? مِن سِفَاحِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. From the lewdness of the period of ignorance. سِفَاح, lewdness here means people who are promiscuous. People who indulge in sexual relations outside of marriage. Outside of marriage. Allah has protected the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from such lewd, such activities. Meaning that all in the lineage and chain and amongst the forefathers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were born in marriage. Okay? The marriages were consummated. And they were born in marriage, meaning their parents did not meet in relations outside of marriage. And thus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had purified the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَكْرِمْ بِهِ مِن نَسَبٍ طَهَّرَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مِن سِفَاحِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. It means that there were people in the period of jahiliyyah, the period of ignorance, who may have had children out of wedlock. But as far as the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was concerned, no one could point a finger and claim that anyone was a child of promiscuity, a child of zina. None of his forefathers were given birth to out of wedlock. Their parents were all married in the recognized marriages of their times. You with me?
So أكرم به من نسب طهره الله تعالى من سفاح الجاهلية.
وأكرم به من نسب طهره الله تعالى من سفاح الجاهلية. وعروف فخار أبيه اليتيمة العصر.
Listen to it again. وأكرم به.
وأكرم به من نسب طهره الله تعالى من سفاح الجاهلية.
Good. Now he mentions his scholar's name. أورد الزين العراقي والده في مورده الهني ورواه. So he mentions الزين العراقي. الزين means the beauty. And this man, the scholar, he used to be referred to as زين الدين, the beauty of the deen. And his origin was Iraq. His origin was Iraq, and therefore he was known as Al-Iraqi. Now Al-Imam Al-Barzanji is mentioning a scholar here, a scholar of hadith and a scholar of the fiqh, Shafi'i fiqh. But this Zayn Al-Iraqi, also known as Zaynuddin Al-Iraqi, was a man who was an authority on in the field of hadith. Okay? So listen, this work here, this entire work, we're busy with the riwayats, Iqdul Jawhar fi Mawlidin Nabi al-Azhar, that we refer to in Cape Town as the riwayats. It was compiled by Imam al-Barzanji, right? But Imam al-Barzanji here in this piece is speaking of another scholar, a scholar who was born in the 8th century, passed away here at the start of the 9th century, 806 Hijri. A famous scholar, Zainuddin al-Iraqi. His name, his actual name was Abdul Rahim bin al-Husayn. But he was referred to as Zainuddin, the beauty of deen. And al-Iraqi, in reference to his origin, Iraq. But he was based in Egypt, in Cairo. He passed away in Cairo. And one of his most famous students was al-Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, who is the famous commentator of the hadith book al-Bukhari. So Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani is the commentator, the one who wrote the famous explanation and commentary on the Sahih, the book of hadith of al-Imam al-Bukhari. The man who wrote this explanation, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, was one of the students of this man, Zainuddin al-Iraqi. And Zainuddin al-Iraqi wrote many books. One of the books he wrote, which speaks of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the occurrences attached to it, relating to it, and spoke of the childhood of the Nabi and the life of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That book's name was Al-Mawridul Hani. Al-Mawridul Hani. Mawrid is a spring, a water place, and Al-Hani means quenching or delicious. Al-Mawridul Hani means the delicious spring or the quenching spring. So Zainuddin al-Iraqi had a book, or has a book, known as Al-Mawridul Hani. And in this book, he documents there with references and authenticated chains that speak of the purity of the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Imam al-Barzanji simply says here, Az-Zayn al-Iraqi mentions this fact in his book, The Quenching Spring, and he has narrated it. He narrated this fact based on chains of narration. So Imam al-Barzanji says here that this scholar, Az-Zayn al-Iraqi, who is a recognized scholar of hadith, has mentioned the fact that the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is pure, and that his forefathers were all born in wedlock. And he also narrates this fact from other scholars and narrates this fact by his chains of narration. أورد الزين العراقي وارده في مورده الهني ورواه. You got that? So this is a scholarly point here, where he's showing you that the statement preceding this, the statement regarding the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had purified the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the promiscuity and lewdness of Jahiliyyah, this fact here is not from his own. This fact here is documented by senior scholars and scholars of hadith like الإمام زين الدين العراقي.
أوردنا الزين العراقي واردا في مورده الهني وروى.
Okay, it sounded like Hadith said أوردنا. It's أورد الزين العراقي. أورد الزين العراقي وارده في مورده الهني وروى. Or you can end, the melody, go down. أورد الزين العراقي وارده في مورده الهني وروى. Was welcome the tune a bit. Then the new rhyme comes in once again. Beautiful. حفظ الإله كرامة لمحمد آباءه الأمجاد صونا لاسمه. This is now just confirming the point again and again, but from different angles. What point? The point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had purified and protected the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حفظ الإله كرامة لمحمد, as an honor to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حفظ الإله, the God, meaning Allah, has preserved. Preserved who? Protected who? آباءه الأمجاد, his noble forefathers. Why did Allah do this? He says here, as an honor to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has protected the forefathers of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? صونًا لِسْمِ, safeguarding his name. صونًا لِإِسْمِهِ, but you can join the, ignore the E and say لِسْمِ. صونًا لِسْمِ, as safeguarding the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so nobody could point finger at him and say, who are you to speak in our midst? Your forefathers were so and so and so and so. No, no one could say that because Allah had preserved the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and protected his forefathers from Allah. Allah had protected the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's forefathers from any promiscuous activity and protected them from any shame of lewdness and any blame or criticism. حفظ الإله كرامة لمحمد آباءه الأمجاد صونا لاسمه.
حفظ الإله كرامة لمحمد آباءه الأمجاد صونا لاسمه.
So صونا لاسمه. حفظ الإله كرامة لمحمد آباءه الأمجاد صونا لاسمه. So for the Arabic students, آباءه is the مفعول به of حفظ. حفظ الإله آباءه الأمجاد. Okay? But why did Allah protect the forefathers, the noble forefathers of Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, كرامة لمحمد, as an honor for Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and صونا لاسمه. So that's showing سبب, showing cause. نعم. So it's مفعول له صونا لاسمه, أي safeguarding the Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم's name. ترك السفاحة فلم يصيبه معاره من آدم وإلى أبيه وأمه. They all تركوا, they left, they abandoned السفاحة, immorality. They abandoned immorality. All his forefathers abandoned immorality. فلم يصيبه معاره. So it's shame. Its shame did not afflict them. Its shame, the shame of immorality, did not afflict the forefathers of Nabi Muhammad. Allah protect us all from such shame, and our children, and our friends and loved ones, and our relatives. Ya Rabb. They all left immorality, and so its shame did not afflict them from Adam right up until his father and his mother, meaning from Adam alayhi salam through to Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. From Ismail alayhi salam through to Adnan, from Adnan through all down the chain to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam's parents, his father Abdullah and his mother Amina. All of them were not promiscuous. All of them did not engage in any immoral acts, and thus they were saved from the shame of immorality. Taraku sifaha falam yusibhu ma'aruh min Adam wa ila abihi.
تركوا السفاح فلم يصبهم عار من آدم وإلى أبيه وأمه.
Good. I've seen in some texts instead of من آدمين, you can say من آدمة. من آدمين or من آدمة, the choice is yours.
تركوا السفاح فلم يصبهم معار من آدم وإلى أبيه وأمه. تركوا السفاح فلم يصبهم معار من آدم وإلى أبيه وأمه.
Good. So there the new or different rhyme, and we go back to the original rhyme, and this is the end. Saratun. Saratun is a plural. It means noble-minded individuals, distinguished individuals. Sara nur nubuwati, the light of prophethood. Sara has emanated and moved. Fi asariri. Asariri is a unique word. It's the plural of sirar, which means the lines here in your forehead. Sirar. Asarir is the plural. In the lines of ghurarihimul bahiyya, in the lines of the brilliantly shining foreheads. So noble individuals, distinguished individuals, who is he speaking of? The forefathers. This whole riwayah, this whole chapter or section, this whole set of information is about the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He first logged it, gave you their names and some of their nicknames and their actual names. And now he's speaking about the fact that beyond just listing their names, we have to know that these were respectable individuals, and these were individuals who were all born in marriage. Naam. And their parents never ever engaged in anything that was immoral. So, and then they were blessed with the nur of Nubuwa that moved through them right up until the parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Saratun, distinguished individuals. Sara nur nubuwati fi asariri ghurarihimul bahiyya, having the light of prophethood emanating in the lines of their brilliantly shining foreheads. Ghurar again is the plural of ghurra, which was used actually as a reference to a black horse with a white spot on its forehead. It's a ghurra, right? The plural is ghurar. So lots of horses with white spots on their foreheads. It's a metaphor, but it's used now to distinguish the forefathers of Rasulullah ﷺ in that they stood out from all the people of their time. Just like a horse with a white mark on its forehead will stand out amongst other horses. But he, brilliantly shining. وَبَدَرَ بَدْرُهُ, and his full moon shone, his full moon rose. Badr is a full moon. His, meaning Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's full moon rose, where? فِي جَبِينِ جَدِّهِ عَبْدُ الْمُطَلِبِ, in the forehead of his grandfather Abdul Muttalib. وَبْنِهِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ, and his son Abdullah. So the Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's full moon, he was more beautiful than the full moon. That genes, that essence, that DNA, oh, here's the reverse. It was passed on through the generations and it ended up in the grandfather, in the forehead of the grandfather of Rasulullah, who was known as Abdul Muttalib. And we remember that his actual name was Shaybah, Shaybatul Hamd, but he was known as Abdul Muttalib. And that full moon, that nur of Rasulullah was passed on to the son of Abdul Muttalib, who was none other than Abdullah, who became the father of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Saratun sara nurun nubuwati fi asariri ghurarihimul bahiyya wa badara badruhu fi jabin jaddihi Abdul Muttalib wa ibnihi Abdullah. I have the word jaddihi in brackets because in some texts it is not there, but it is fine to put it there, and I think Hadi Osman reads the word jaddi. So in some texts it's simply wa badara badruhu fi jabin Abdul Muttalib wa ibnihi Abdullah, and his full moon rose and appeared in the forehead of Abdul Muttalib and the forehead of his son Abdullah.
Saratun saran nurun nubuwati fi asarir ghurarihimul البهية.
Perfect.
وبدر بدره في جبين جده عبد المطلب وابنه عبد الله.
سرات سرى نور النبوة في أسارير غررهم البهية. وبدر بدره في جبين جده عبد المطلب وابنه عبد الله.
Good. Practice. That's the end. And therefore the reader will then proclaim this unique salutation. عطر اللهم
عطر. In some texts I've seen, instead of Al-Kareem, readers will say Sharif. عطر اللهم قبره الشريف, which also means noble. Which also means noble. It's okay, but Kareem is the most common. And then the audience, along with the reader, salutes. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi. Okay. I'm not going to recap on the start of the second riwaya now. Rather, you recap, and next week I'll play the first riwaya as well as the second riwaya, just play it out, and then we'll address the third one, insha'Allah. May Allah increase our love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May He grant us understanding, and may He open more doors of understanding for us so we can take all our verbal rituals to a higher level. And a higher level of spirituality. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. And may He grant us all to be deserving of His love, Jalla Jalaluhu, via our love for Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and His love for His Messenger, Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. May Allah continue to protect us, grant us well-being, and inshallah, if Allah wills, we will continue with this beautiful journey next week, inshallah. Keep well. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.